your outdoor knife even better? Well, today we're going to take a look at a few easy, simple mods that you can do to make your system better equipped for bushcrafting and outdoor survival. Let's get into this. Hey guys, so today, like I said, we're going to be taking a look at a few simple mods to make just about any knife system better for survival. This cantankerous sheath out of the way, so we can first take a look at the few mods that we are going to talk about when it comes to the actual knife itself. So the first mod, and before I jump into the mods, I'm going to talk about why you might want to mod a knife. Now, some of these mods I'm going to talk about, quite a few survival knives, good survival knives, actually have already done to them. However, that isn't necessarily the truth to all systems, and sometimes you need a system that's better. Like, a lot of people may ask, well, why don't you just go with a Mora Garberg? Well, turns out that I like the CPMS 35VN steel of this knife, and I like the size and weight of this knife better than I like a Garberg, or rather, this fits my needs better than a Garberg ever could. So that's just one of the reasons why you may be more inclined to modding a knife system as opposed to making a knife system work for you that already has these mods. So now let's jump into the couple mods that I did to this actual blade. So the first one is a spine grind. I think this is the most important thing to do to a knife. Now, unfortunately, I didn't get any cool GoPro footage of the spine grind, but it's very basic. I took a Dremel, and in a similar process to me doing the next mod, I just ground and kept grinding and grinding, and I made sure it took some time because I made sure that every time I hit this with the sanding disc, I was coming at it at a 90 degree angle. And I just wore down the rounded spine, like you guys can see up here, this is rounded. I just wore it down till this, you know, about inch and a half surface right here was flat, 90 degrees sharp. And then, you know, I threw some sparks off of it to make sure it would work. So doing a simple spine grind is the number one thing. And I think that this is the most important step because it'll allow you to get more functionality out of your knife in regards to being able to strike ferro rod with it and start fires, which is an extremely important thing in survival and bushcraft. So the next thing, if you guys remember this good old knife, it had a frontal guard up here because this was designed to be more of a combat knife. So the next thing was to remove the upper guard or to grind the guard off of that. And so it was a guard reduction or delete. And some of your more combative knives, like your K-bars and like this knife, have a upper guard for kind of combat-esque things. I don't really know why. It's not very realistic, and you're not gonna like glance off another knife or some stupid stuff like that. But for whatever reason, they had a guard up here. And so what I did was I didn't completely delete it, and I'm actually kind of testing to see if this reduction will work. So far, I actually like the reduction quite a bit, and it's just fine for me. What I did, and once again, this is a very expensive knife that I did these things too, but I wanted to make the knife more functional, but I still wanted to keep the quality there. So I carefully, once again, similar to this, I carefully took my time and I gave it side bevels so that this is comfortable to put your thumb on or your thumb to be around. So if you see here, you know, like I can, you know, move my thumb on this and it feels comfortable at all angles. There's no sharp spots on it. And then I lastly took a polishing compound and I polished it out, so it now looks now feels all polished and nice and comfortable. It's not as rough as it once was when I was sanding it off. So that was the next thing that I did to this knife. Now, the third thing, and I wanted to throw this out there, some knives need this, other knives like this one did not need this, but another good thing to do, especially if you're working with a micarta or a G10, is grip modifications. I know some of the knives I've had in the past, especially Bark River knives, if I were going to be using them as much as I use this, I would take the Dremel and similarly to, you know, grinding things like this, I would cut slots, kind of like what you see here with these three slots here or with these slots up here. I would just cut grip into them so that they feel better, rougher, and more grippy. However, like I said, this knife already has a very aggressive, very well done grip to it, so I don't need any modifying of the grip. But I did want to throw it out there as a grip modification. Now, that's the knife, and that is pretty much as you can realistically do to a knife to make it better for survival. However, the last point was, and like I said, this is something that you're either going to like or not like. Personally, as big as this is, I never really found it to catch on anything. But the last thing is, if your sheath can take it, like this sheath has a very good molly attachment to the front of it, the last thing to do is add a really good PSK or survival kit to it. Personally, for myself, I'm getting more out of my big Janus pack that I used to carry for my personal survival kit and going more towards this system, because what I liked better about having a PSK that runs alongside your nice survival knife is the fact that you get a very high quality, very strong, resilient, and overall, you know, good survival knife, and then complementing that with the ferro rods, the tinder quicks, the, you know, different things that you have in your PSK, you know, cliff bars, whatever you're going to have in here. So it helps round out your knife, and it makes your knife system better at a survival situation. So ultimately, I'm not going to dig into this because I have other videos that dig into this kit here, but it's really a smart idea, and it's a practical thing to have at least a small, it doesn't have to be this expansive or this comprehensive, but some sort of personal survival kit on board your survival knife. And like I said, it makes your survival knife better, and it makes your survival kit better because you're pairing it with something really capable and something really capable. So anyways, these are four practical things that you can pretty easily do if you have a Dremel and some time, and you know your sheath can harness that type of thing. And a lot of sheaths can take on, you know, survival kits, and a lot of knives can be pretty easily Dremeled. Like I said, this is S35VN, which is not an easy steel, but a good sanding wheel, like I think I have on here still, something like this one, or just your sanding wheels on your Dremel, are really great and really fast at taking away that material and making your knives more useful. Because while some people may see this as destroying the value of the knife, I have no intentions of getting rid of this knife, so the value isn't as high there for me in making it look like it was out of box, but rather making it more useful. And I love having that guard just ground down, and like I said, being able to strike the ferro rod from back here. So anyways, those are some practical mods. Thought I'd go over them with you guys and show you how to get the most out of just about any knife system. Anyways, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.